नमस्कार दोस्तों, द टाइटल ऑफ द स्टोरी टुडे इज 100 गोल्ड कॉइन्स एंड बीरबल। आई हैव गॉन थ्रू अ लॉट ऑफ बीरबल स्टोरीज, द अकबर बीरबल स्टोरीज दीस डेज, सो आई एम नरेटिंग टू यू द इंटरेस्टिंग वंस आउट ऑफ दैट। द विजडम ऑफ बीरबल वॉज अनपैरेलल्ड ड्यूरिंग द रेन ऑफ एम्परर अकबर, बट अकबर्स ब्रदर इन लॉ वॉज एक्सट्रीमली जेलस ऑफ हिम। ही आस्क्ड द एम्परर टू डिस्पेंस विद बीरबल्स services and appoint him in his place. He gave ample assurance that he would prove to be more efficient and capable than Birbal. But before Akbar could take a decision on the matter, the news reached Birbal, and Birbal on his own resigned and left. Akbar's brother-in-law was made the minister in place of Birbal. Akbar decided to test the new minister. He gave 300 gold coins to him and said, "Go and spend these gold coins in such a manner that I get 100 gold coins here in this life, 100 gold coins in the other world, and another gold coin, another 100 gold coins, neither here nor there." The minister found the entire situation to be a maze of confusion and hopelessness. He got nervous. He spent sleepless nights worrying how he would get himself out of this mess. Thinking in circles was making him go crazy. Eventually, on the advice of his wife, he sought Birbal's help. Birbal said, "Just give me the gold coins and I shall handle the situation." Birbal walked the streets of the city holding the bag of gold coins in his hands. He noticed a rich merchant celebrating his son's wedding. Birbal gave 100 gold coins to him and bowed courteously, saying that the Emperor Akbar sends you his good wishes and blessings for the wedding of your son. Please accept the gift he has sent. The merchant was very happy. He felt very honored that the king had sent a special messenger with such a precious gift. He honored Birbal and gave him a large number of expensive gifts and even a bag of gold coins as a return gift for the king. Next, Birbal went to the area of the city where the poor people lived. There he bought food and clothing in exchange for 100 gold coins and distributed them in the name of the emperor. When he came back to town, he organized a concert of music and dance. He spent 100 gold coins on it. The next day, Birbal entered Akbar's darbar and announced that he had done all that the king had asked him to do. Or rather, the king's brother-in-law had asked him to do. The emperor wanted to know what he had done. Birbal repeated the sequences of all the events and then said, "The money I gave to the merchant for the wedding of his son, you have got back while on this earth." So here is the bag of coins that he gave. "The money I spent on buying food and clothing for the poor, you will get it in the other world when you are no more. The money I spent on the musical concert, you will get neither here nor there." Akbar's brother-in-law understood his mistake and resigned from the services of Akbar. Birbal got his place back. So friends, the moral of the story is, the money you spend on friends is returned and reciprocated in some form or the other in this life only. The money spent on charity gets converted into blessings from God, which will be your eternal property. The money spent on pleasures is just frittered away. So think wisely before you spend your money. Goodbye and see you soon.